Okay, let's start.
Okay. I had a lucid dream last night, and it's a demonstration of why you don't need any fancy techniques or, you know, things like this. What's the quickest and easiest way to get lucid? I'm going to show you and detail exactly what happened in this lucid dream so that you can be in complete understanding that you need very little actual stuff to become lucid. So last night I had this dream that I was in Denmark with the woman, and we were in the shop, and I'm looking around in the shop, and it's like a counter, like a big wooden counter on one side, and then there's like huge shopping area, but it's almost like the counter is raised up a little bit. It's on a couple of steps, so you have to walk up the steps to put your stuff on the counter for the person behind the counter to like charge you for the stuff. And within the floor of the shop, it's fairly small-ish, but it's got a couple of rows of like items on shelving every now and then, but the shelves are small enough so that I can like look above and over them. So it's a small little independent shop in Denmark, and I've never been to Denmark, and this was like number one for like, what the hell am I doing here in Denmark? But I'm walking around in the shop, and behind the counter is somebody that I recognize, and I look at him and I'm like, oh, I know that person. And I say to the woman, I'm like, you know that guy that I talked about where, you know, he had a really low voice, and he once said to me that he doesn't want to see how low he can go, because if he does, he'll be afraid that he starts cracking the foundations of the building that he's in. He had a low voice. And I look at the woman, and she's just completely like, what are you talking about? That was a true real life thing that happened to me, actually, that guy. And I'm looking, I was like, it's that guy, remember that guy? And she was like, I don't know about that. So I walk up to the counter and I, you know, introduce myself, and I'm like, oh, do you remember who I am? And he's like, no, I don't really remember who you are. I said, I'm from Cornwall. And he's like, oh, I'm from Cornwall as well. I said, I know you're from Cornwall, I recognize you, you're Thingamajig's friend. And he was like, yeah, I am. I said, we went to the cinema together to watch this film, don't you remember? It's like, oh yeah, I remember. So I then look around the room, and I notice that the people, the staff, some of the customers, are all people that I know from growing up within Cornwall. And I think, no, this isn't right. How comes there's so many people here in Denmark? So then I see someone who's like leant up against the counter, and she's crying, and I recognize her, and I like try and console her, with Alice's help, of course. And we're, you know, like, what's wrong? What's wrong? And then she just like buries her head into like my armpit and just cries uncontrollably. And I'm like, well, I don't know what to do in this situation. So I just like pat her back, not like a dog, but, you know, just making her comfortable. And then she stops crying. And then she recognizes me from Cornwall and recognizes that I do lucid dreaming videos. So she said to me, oh, what is the protocol for lucid dreaming? I said, what do you mean? What's the protocol for lucid dreaming? She said, what do you have to do to become lucid in a dream if you are in the dream? And I said, well, there's a couple of things you could do. You could do A, B, C, or D, you know, there's, you know, you can ask yourself where you are, and, you know, things like that. And at this point, nothing really clicked in my mind that this was a dream. It was just like, oh, this is something that's happening. Until I said to her, and my favorite thing to do to become lucid is you pinch your nose to see if you can breathe through it. And I pinched my nose and I could breathe through it. And then I said audibly, I went, oh, God damn it, like that. And I became lucid. And I'm looking through and I was like, obviously, this is a dream. But there's a couple of things that I've learned from this experience. Number one, warp factor 5. Now, number one was that when I pinch my nose to see if I can breathe through it, every time I've done that in a dream, I've been able to breathe through it. But also every time that I've been able to breathe through my nose in a dream, it always feels like I've got a snotty nose. Like I pinch it and no matter how much I go like that, it's like I can't quite get enough oxygen up into my nose. It's like I'm struggling to breathe. And I think that could easily go under the radar if you're doing this in a dream as, oh, you know, I've likely let some air into my nose instead of pinching it real hard and trying to breathe through it. I'm actually letting a little bit of air in. So it's important to know that, like, even if it's obstructed breathing in that dream, in that pinched nose situation, it still can be, you know, a lucid dream. So just be aware of that. And the second thing I noticed about this was the fact that I'm not currently writing my dreams down in a dream journal. I do have a good amount of sleep, and yesterday I went for a very long walk, so I was knackered by the time I got home. But it goes to show that even though I'm not recording any dreams in my dream journal, I'm not actively being assertive in my lucid dreaming endeavors. I'm not trying to become lucid all the time. It's just something that is happening. I'm not doing any techniques, or I'm not trying any fancy things like, oh, the quickest way to become lucid. None of that. I just was lucid in a dream. And the third reason that, well, the reason that's important, not the third reason, but the reason those are important is that it demonstrates that you don't need any fancy techniques or methodologies or, you know, whatever you want to call them to become lucid. You don't need to eat a specific diet of whatever. You just need to be able to think critically when a situation happens. So I was kind of under the radar when it came to that Denmark dream where I was looking at everyone. I was like, why is everyone here? You know, I was questioning that, and I already had that critical mindset. But then I was distracted by this person crying, and then that person was talking to me about lucid dreaming, which kind of indicates to me that I was already half there by myself without the dream intervening. So it's possible, perfectly possible, to become lucid by thinking critically, singularly. But equally, it's also important to recognize that even though this is the only thing that you're going to be doing, or if it is, you can still get a lot of help by the other factors. So by having a good dream journal or dream recall is a great factor that will help you become lucid. By doing some techniques to become lucid, it will help you become lucid. By having a good diet or a good exercise program will help you become lucid. By getting enough sleep will help you become lucid. And all these factors play in a part. So if you are struggling to become lucid in your dreams and you're not doing everything you can to try and maximize your potential by having a good dream journal, sleeping well, blah, 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 like I just said, then don't worry. If you just take on a couple more attributes of positive, healthy, lucid dreaming practice, you'll increase those chances. I became very lucky in this dream. I become very lucky in this dream because the dream kind of started me off on that journey. But yeah, it's possible to do it without, but it's improbable. And that's pretty much it for today. I do want to say that I've started Project Morpheus, and if you want to be involved in Project Morpheus, it was the last video I made on this channel, and also the link to the Discord is in the description box below. But until then, I'll see you next time, and